Yo, what up? It's Cloud Rap Sensation and Film Extra Extraordinaire, Best Boy Grip. Welcome to my film workshop. All right, let's jump right in and start showcasing some of the many celebrities that have benefited from my full program, available at sumscorp.org.
Hey, my name is Pablo. You've probably seen me on Ellen or Good Morning America discussing Kanye West. But I wouldn't be YouTube famous if it weren't for this program.
Yo, what up? It's Cloud Rap Sensation and Film Extra Extraordinaire, Best Boy Grip. Welcome to my film workshop. All right, let's jump right in and start showcasing some of the many celebrities that have benefited from my full program, available at sumscorp.org.
Hey, my name is Pablo. You've probably seen me on Ellen or Good Morning America discussing Kanye West. But I wouldn't be YouTube famous if it weren't for this program.
Man, I'm sorry, but in 2016, amping up the gain on doom metal tracks doesn't count as musical
just
talent.
Forget about the harsh noise for a second.
You brought it up.
It's 2016, new season. We're focusing on
vaporwave.
Woo! Fuck off. Man, I was up late last night thinking about profound, intellectual, smart guy stuff. I asked myself, Adriano, you're a nearly perfect being. You should be great at all mediums of art.
How can you be a talented musician without an ounce of musical talent? Vaporwave. I realized that if I can edit together music as well as I can edit together films, there's nothing stopping me from becoming a fucking legend. And so my first Vaporwave single was born.
Well, let's get it over with.
All right, Sums, you ready to change the world? Let's do it!
Who's gonna tell you when? It's too late.
Adrian.
What?
That's drive by the car slow to a crawl.
Wow, another asinine observation by the simple-minded Sums.
Oh.
What do you know?
I guess you feel like you're innovating with this track.
I am innovating.
It's going to be a lasting cultural artifact with which you're going to revolutionize a dying internet fad.
It's not a fucking fad! Vaporwave is not a fad! Come on. I think you're confusing C-Punk with Vaporwave. No, C-Punk, that's the fad. No depth. No, Vaporwave has endured the test of time. And as long as consumerism flourishes in this capitalist society, Vaporwave will reign supreme. Macintosh Plus was just the beginning.
Look, Adrian, you're one of my best friends, so you of all people should know that I am a lover of music. And I've listened to my fair share of Vaporwave. But I think it speaks volumes of a genre when the very best it has to offer is the shit that's solely composed of slowed down soul samples drenched in reverb obnoxiously. Blank Banshee can suck my dick. All that other shit. No.
Hear me out. Close your eyes. Listen to the background music. Isn't it so ethereal? Absolutely atmospheric. Vaporwave just satisfies my musical libido. Don't you understand?
Man, I know you don't want to hear this, but I genuinely believe that 95% of Vaporwave is too sloppily composed and low concept to even be properly defined.
Well, actually, Vaporwave is a microgenre that emerged in the early 2010s among internet communities.
Precisely. It's a microgenre. No tours, no monetization, no radio play, no tangible fan base. It's not real.
False. Vectroid has toured like half the US.
That's because she jump-started the entire fucking genre of meme music.
Don't call it meme music. I mean, Floral Shop is really influential, but when people think of Vaporwave, they think of Blank Banshee. Like, come on.
Don't even try and bullshit me. Don't try and even tell me that you don't dick ride the fuck out of Floral Shop, okay? You know, I'm sure you've done it. You ever punched a Vaporwave into the old Google search bar?
You know
bar?
I have.
You ever take a Vaporwave, punch it in the old Google search bar? What do you get, Adrian? I know, I don't hear it. What do you get?
The first thing that comes up is Lisa.
It's Frank 420, yeah. Yeah.
Look, I'm not talking about Google stats. I'm here representing all the Vaporwave communities from 4chan and Reddit.
It's a noble cause. Posting shallow art on 4chan that so succinctly depicts your inner nihilism and your so strongly held convictions regarding anti-consumerism.
In a cosmic sort of way, yes. I mean, it's just something I'm into right now, and my art's obviously gonna reflect it.
It's gonna bleed over into season 3.
No, it's not.
Dude. You're still wearing the tracksuit.
Tracksuits have nothing to do with Vaporwave!
Then why are you still wearing it?
Cause it's the preferred aesthetic.
Name one other person that regularly wears a tracksuit.
Dimitri, the cameraman.
Who?
Now I know you're fucking with me. I bet you $10 that if I called Savannah right now, she'd be in full Adidas. In fact, I've got her on speed dial. Hello?
Hello?
Haha, yes! I knew it. Talk to you later.
What?
See? Full Adidas.
How the hell would you know what she was wearing? You couldn't see shit. What,
dude,
do you have some six?
No, it doesn't matter. You know why?
What?
Fuck! You! It's time for you to join the health goth lifestyle.
Okay, look. I've got my own lifestyle and my own aesthetic. Max. Beach.
Max Beach.
Look, just put it on. The channel is at stake here. Do you understand?
Look,
I don't need you projecting your own aesthetic bullshit!
It's not aesthetic bullshit!
Ow! Ow! Fuck! Ow! Ow! Ow!
No! Ah!
Yeah, motherfucker! No!
What the fuck, dude?! This is my best fucking shoot!
Hi, my name's Jason Repair, and I'm your virtual tour guide through the greatest nation on Earth, USA. On August 26, 2016, I was diagnosed with terminal cancer. And instead of seeking treatment, I'm gonna let the Lord take care of it all. And I'm gonna travel around and see the world before I die, if I die, if the good Lord wills it. Let's go! My time spent at the world-famous Arkansas-Vietnam War Veteran Memorial has been a blast, but I'm feeling hungry. Mamma mia. Mamma mia, I could go for a slice. Good thing I'm here at Bruno's Italian Villa in Benton, Arkansas, 10 miles outside of Little Rock. Let's check it out.
Hey, welcome. What are you guys waiting over here? Come on in.
Oh, thank you, sir.
How y'all doing tonight?
I'm doing all right, sir.
All right, all right. Are y'all ready to eat over here in the best Italian food? I mean, real the best food, my kid.
Yes, sir.
All right. Let me take you to a table and let's see what we got around here.
Excellent.
Come on.
Let's go.
How's this table over here?
Oh, it's excellent. Thank you, sir.
Right.
Well, folks.
Are you doing a good job around here or what?
Well, that's our cameraman.
What's his name anyway?
It's Dimitri.
Dimitri. What kind of name is that?
It's Serbian, sir.
Oh, you brought a Serbian over here?
Yeah,
Well, welcome over here. Come on in.
Okay, great. Thank you, sir. Gosh, it's so delectable. There's so many different items to choose from. Maybe I'm going to get a pizza pie. I think I'm going to get...
How are you doing today, Mr. Gentleman?
Oh, I'm doing all right, sir. And your name is?
My name is Sumner Sanders. I'm the establishment manager of this restaurant, Bruno's Italian Villa.
Oh, well, nice to meet you, sir.
Certainly. Certainly.
Well, how long have you been working here?
Well, let me tell you, I've been in and out of the restaurant biz, you know, for upwards of 15 years now. But steakhouses, burger joints. But I've been here at the Villa for 2 years and change. And I gotta say, I do enjoy working for Bruno.
Oh wow, that must be a big deal working under Bruno like that. He's well known around these parts.
Indeed, man. You know, when it's good, it's great. You're rolling in it, and when it's bad, you gotta stay on your toes. You know, but overall, I'd give it been quite a pleasant experience.
You have a wonderful menu, and I just don't know what to choose, but I've really been eyeing a pizza pie. So I have to ask you, what pizza pie should I get?
Look, Jason, my friend, Gaffietti drove in all the way out of state for Triple D for our deluxe lunchable pizza.
Deluxe lunchable pizza?
Can't go wrong.
That sounds extraordinary.
It's extraordinary. And now you got a choice of a soup or a salad with that.
A choice. You know what? I think I'm going to try a salad.
All right. Now we're here in the Villa salad room where the salads get prepared. Jason has opted for a Greek salad. Now we're fixing to get started on his base. Now let me explain to you, here at the Villa, we got a choice of three different salad bases. You got your standard lettuce, we utilize romaine, but then you got your barbecue lays, and you got your Cheetos. So Jason has opted for a Cheeto base, so we're gonna get some Cheetos, throw them in the bowl, mix them up. You know, standard salad ingredients, you got your tomatoes, toss those in there, you got some cucumbers, got a little bit of pinch of onion, then you just, now here we got our special Greek dressing. Now for my favorite customers, VIPs and such, I like to give them an extra heaping portion of it. See what I'm saying? Mr. Repair, did you enjoy your salad?
I certainly enjoyed it, sir. It was delicious. One of the best salads I've ever had.
Glad to hear it. Well, here I have for you the house special.
Wow.
The Lunchable Deluxe.
The Lunchable Deluxe.
Indeed.
Well, sir.
Finest available.
It looks kind of uncooked.
It's the house special. The Lunchable Deluxe.
Oh.
Enjoy.
Bon appetit. Well, folks, let's give it a taste. Mmm. Delicioso, mamma mia, that's a good pie. I'm here at the River Market, the cultural hotspot for Little Rock, Arkansas, in the smack dab middle of downtown. It's pretty thriving. For some, the River Market District is the lifeblood of Little Rock's downtown scene, and for others, it's a great place to do business, a place to grab a marvelous meal or meet up with some friends and catch some great Arkansas live music. No matter who you are, the River Market District is a good time. A parade for Donald Trump's inauguration was held here today. There were over 9,000 people in attendance. It was beautiful. I saw this amazing float that featured God and Trump hand in hand, side by side, sitting on this mass of Islamic terrorists drinking from Muhammad's bowl. Like, how more patriotic can you get? Oh, come here. Excuse me, sir, excuse me. Did you come from that bookstore right? Well, is it closing soon? Because we're doing this virtual tour thing and that was our next spot.
Oh, well, yeah, it's closed, but it's actually my place of business. You could come back and...
It's your place.
Yeah, it's mine.
Well, that makes you Julian Myers, doesn't it? Yes. You're my absolute favorite author.
Well, thank you. I'm flattered, but you see, it's way too late. I really have to
be
going.
Wait, please. One question. Is it true they're making a film adaptation of Adventures of a Post Human through time and space?
How did you... I can neither confirm nor... Why am I even talking to you? My wife is going into labor, and my car's parked all the way over there. I didn't have time to move it after the parade. There were just so many people, and it was over. I can't talk to you. I've really got
to
be going.
It's okay. Why did you even stop to talk to me then?
The notoriety!
You heard it here first, folks. Julian Myers. Fun fact! Little Rock and New Orleans are the only two cities in the South where prostitution is fully legalized. I'm here now at the Summit House, the largest brothel in the South. The producers have already set me up with an appointment on the 12th floor with a Miss Atlanta Geyser. Apparently, the 12th floor is home of the $6 hand job, so let's go on up and find out what we're in for. We're here now at the fabled 12th floor. Let's head on in and see what's going on. Hello.
Well, hi there.
I'm Jason the Repair.
I'm Atlanta Geyser.
Atlanta Geyser, nice to meet you.
Well, it's nice to meet you, Jason.
How long have you been doing this business, if you don't mind me asking?
Well, I've been in this a long time. Ever since the 80s.
The 80s.
The 80s.
Interesting. And I hear that you're home of the $6 fabled hand job. Is that true?
I am, sir. Have you come around looking for one of these $6 hand jobs?
Well, yeah, I guess so, yeah.
Well, let's get down to business.
What's going on? Is this where we...
This is the waiver.
A waiver?
The waiver.
A waiver for what?
I'm HIV positive. That's not a problem, is it?
No. That's fine, no.
I mean,
Yeah. I know, I understand. Yeah, here, just give me a pen and yeah, I'll take care of this right now.
Turn the fucking light on.
Okay, fine. What is it?
Dude, are you sure you want to go through with this hand job?
It might be the only chance I'll ever get to get an actual hand job. Like, I think the risk is worth it.
Let's do it. I'm sorry. Okay.
Like, yeah, just trust me. It'll be fine. It'll be fine.
All right.
Welcome to our handy station. Let's go ahead and get started here. We have a variety of lubrication options.
Okay.
You could do tall, you could do grande, you do verde, or if you're feeling deluxe, We have the Trenta option, if you're up for it.
I think I could be up for it.
Excellent.
Alright, this is the Summit House $6 Trenta-sized hand job going in. See you on the other side.
I'll be gentle. I'll lift that shirt up, boy.
Okay.
Hey, what's going on? It's Adriano. You may have seen me on Star Wars Sith posting on Facebook.com. Well, on November 29th, 2016, I made a very silly text post that read, if this gets 3,720 reacts, I will get
Tell that to Kanja Club
tattooed on me in the font of the highest rated comments choice. And so here we are at Lucky Bella Tattoo in Maumelle, Arkansas, the white privilege capital of the US.
So let's head on inside and see what Howard has for us.
Tell that to Kanja Club. Tell that to Kanja Club.
Hey, what's going on, guys? It's Adriano from The Mooring Line. I'm here in Los Angeles doing a mockumentary, a rock mockumentary with Rocket Coma. What up? It's gonna be sick, dude. It's gonna be killer. Who knows what's gonna happen, man? Who's, you know? I've been gone for the last 2 weeks. I'm gonna come back after the new year and we're gonna make some crazy films, all right? It's gonna be sick. I'm wasting my life away, but it's gonna be sick. All right, cool. See you after the new year.
We haven't uploaded anything since February. This is getting ridiculous.
Yeah, it fucking sucks, dude. But we gotta be honest here. No one wants to watch you make videos by yourself.
You know, you're right. I just gotta force Sumner out of his creative hibernation for the sake of art.
Oh, Sumner. I know no one can sleep 19 hours, Sumner, and that's not real. I'm gonna have to come in there, okay? Even if it's to check the time of death.
You know I hate to bother you, but I really gotta... Look, I could care less if you think that the universe is a hologram or think that Elon Musk is a goddamn lizard man. That's your business, all right? I need you to get the fuck up right now and shoot a goddamn YouTube video with me. Even if it's just experimental imagery like we used to do, you know, we gotta shoot something. Man, do you remember March this time last year when we were in the exact same creative rut that we're in now and we had to make a semi-fictional video to explain to the audience why we weren't putting out regular videos? Well, we gotta make another one, again. And we gotta make it somehow even more self-aware than last time.
Dude, what you don't seem to understand is that the self-awareness doesn't matter to me so much anymore as the cosmic awareness. Okay? Cosmic awareness via means of meta self-reprogramming. A guy like you ought to be able to wrap your mind around that.
Dude, you gotta stop throwing around the word cosmic, okay? You're starting to sound like Mr. Robot.
Dude, you ever crack open a dictionary when you're not memeing your life down the shitter? My name literally means one who summons. Now, Take, if you will, a moment and consider the cosmic implications of that, dude. To summon spirits and energy, what that could mean for my destiny, let alone our collective destiny, is worth exploring, okay?
This is pointless, man. Just absolutely pointless. That's like Cody moved to Colorado and Sumner's trying to get to the fifth dimension.
More like the 12th dimension. Am I right?
Maybe I could just reboot the channel and start doing Let's Plays or movie reviews or some shit like that. What? I don't think so, pal. Let's Plays? Are you fucking serious? Are you joking right now? Are you out of your fucking mind? While you're reevaluating what you just fucking said to me, I'm gonna go inside and take care of old Sums and get the ball rolling.
Sumner, hey buddy.
Hey,
what's going on?
Hey, what's up?
Well, I just, I heard you were a little dry in the bud department lately.
That is true.
So I rolled you up a little surprise.
Is that so?
A hash cig.
Dude, I can't smoke on the patio.
Grow up, dude. Jesus.
Well, what'd you use for tobacco? Your Rillo guts? Shit.
American spirits.
Well, if that's the case, I think I can step out for a moment.
Man, we just gotta find a way to reincorporate Cody again, you know? It's gotta be me, him, you, the trifecta. Dude, please don't make that triangle like that. Like, that shit's tripping me out.
What?
I'm gonna go back home and stay with my parents a little while.
Back to the summit.
Yo, what's up?
Hey, what's up, dude?
Not much. Hey, I'm smoking outside of my parents. I got matches. Give me some.
Okay, well.
I'm getting there. Okay.
All right, I had to check and see if you were still at your parents' house, and I can see that you are, which is very disconcerting, because, listen, I was coming upstairs, just like normal, and I come in, the door's locked, but all the lights are on, every single one of them.
I mean, did you give, like, Savannah a key or something?
No, I didn't give her a key. What I'm saying is that it was all, you know, the lights were on and all that.
But here's where it gets deranged, okay? There was a Happy Meal just sitting on the table. A Happy Meal.
That's... If you look at the subtext, that's kind of demented.
First of all, McDonald's is bottom tier fast food. Everyone knows that. Who eats McDonald's, let alone a Happy Meal?
Then the Happy Meal's the bottom tier of the bottom tier. Like, that's the bottom of the nugget bucket.
A Happy Meal? Like, what the fuck? What is going on?
You wonder if it had anything to do with that fucking Taco Bell receipt you got? Lady the cashier was like, you know.
How the fuck did you know about my Taco Bell receipt?
Hello, Mickey D's, and thank you for watching my Ronald McDonald audition tape that I've prepared for all day. I just hope that you understand how much of a fan I am of the original Ronald McDonald. And I love your commercials, and I love your products. So please take the time and see if I'm the right choice. Okay, here we go. Hey kids. We have hamburgers. What if you like cheese? We have cheeseburgers. And that's my idea. So please take the consideration and let me know what you think, because I'd be really glad to hear back from you. Okay, bye.
First, anyone want another donut? Anyone? Okay. Listen, you guys know that I wouldn't have called you here unless it was the utmost importance.
I'm just here for the free weed, honestly.
What was your name again?
Cloud Rap Sensation, Best Boy Grip.
And you're in what, one video? I really doubt if Adrian will even notice if you're here or not, so you don't have to stay. It's not a big deal.
I'm also at the end of Soundscapes 3, asshole.
Oh, right. You mean the video that no one watched. Okay.
Yeah, like the videos you're in get so much more viewership. Come on.
Oh yeah? Well, at least I have my own video.
Can we talk about the real tragedy here? How is it that Adrian still hasn't made a sequel to The Life of Pablo, when I'm obviously the best character at this table?
See, it's your false claim that actually brings me to my point. Now, Adrian could make a sequel to The Life of Pablo, among many other fun new projects. but his creativity has been suppressed due to the lack of Sumner and Cody. And as I said in Hash Cigarette, no one wants to watch him make videos by himself, you know?
To be fair, Happy Meal was pretty fucking good. And that was 100% Adrian.
He got lucky, okay? You're missing the point, Audrey. If he continues doing these solo videos, we're all gonna be out of our virtual jobs. I mean, maybe a couple of cameos here and there, but this is it. Pablo, if you ever wanted to see a Kanye sequel, or Audrey, you ever wanted to see some sort of Moon Men reboot, we have to come up with a plan right now to get Sumner out of his slump and back up to the Summit House.
This is really bad.
Okay, Adrian will be finishing up that fat shit any minute now. And as soon as he comes out, we have to hit him with nothing but encouragement. Or we let Sumner do what he needs to fucking do, and we have Adrian call Cody and convince him to come back. Oh, yeah, okay. Let's just call Cody up. Let's have Adrian call Cody and be like, hey man, listen, I know you've been settled in Colorado for almost a year now, but I'm gonna need you to come back to Arkansas so you can film some fucking stupid shit with me. Yeah, that'll work. Okay. The sooner we get Cody back, the quicker we get more Midman. Oh God. The Midman was retired, okay? After the Moon Men arc, no more Midman, all right? If we get Cody back, it's gonna be nothing but fresh material. Look at you, always trying to be in charge and boss people around. I miss the Midman. He makes this channel and you know it. You always think you know what's best for the channel. Well, you don't. You're overly cocky and I honestly don't even understand why I'm at this meeting right now. You seem to have a very narrow view of things, okay? I'm not being cocky. I, Adriano, am literally the greatest director that is and will ever be. Oh God, you Adrian over there has the potential for greatness, okay? He's just lacking in direction and focus. It's mildly ironic. But that's why we must guide him.
Wait, so you're not the real Adrian? Are you real?
You can call me the embodiment of his past, future, and present. Actually, no, disregard that. That's a fucking oversimplification, like big time. Just ignore it. Y'all figure it out eventually.
Wait, so am I real?
If you want to be, Pablo, you can.
Oh God.
All right, let's have a vote. Raise your hand if you want Adrian to get Sumner back. And now Cody? Oh my God, okay, fine. When Adrian gets out of the bathroom, we'll have him break the tie. Stop right there, all right? It's time for you to make a decision right now. No context, who do you choose? Sumner or Cody?
Oh, you bastard. Don't say, no, don't listen to him. Don't listen to him. Listen, no.
How's that fair? I don't even know the context. I don't know what's going on. Sumner or Cody?
So the producers over at the Mooring Line have set me up with a cultural guide named Gustav Noel, and he knows Denver really well. He's here to show us the ins and outs of marijuana culture, and, I believe, how to safely smoke it without having a panic attack. I wouldn't normally smoke marijuana unless it was legalized, so here in Colorado, I'm willing to give it a try, simply for the new cultural experience. And we're waiting on him to get here. He should be here any minute now.
Thank you.
roads might need a guide around town, man.
Oh, Gustav, hello. Hi, what's going on?
That's great, man.
Sir!
Where are you at?
Oh my god.
What? Where are you, man?
Sir, I just... Are you serious? I thought we were supposed to be going
Jason.
To Denver. Yes, I'm Jason LaPere.
I'm ready.
Okay.
I'm tired.
Look. Faint. Fuzzy. Woke up. How long's that for?
About 25 minutes. I had to sit idly.
It's about how long it
twiddle
takes.
My thumbs. For what?
Midman can eat. I mean, ghost of Earth.
I gotta get a look at these clogs!
Okay, so this is your absolute favorite room in all of Colorado?
No, man, let me tell you. This is the most Colorado place you can go to. It has lights, it has a sound. This place is real. It's a party. It's happening.
Yeah, it's pretty happening, I'd say, but this is a toy store, you know? Not much room to do stuff. This is a
This is the dank pit, man. This is where you come and get scrapey, and start stretching, man.
I can get down with that.
Hey, man. Buy more to me?
No. They were completely out. The everything sold out because of this holiday. I still don't understand what this holiday is, but that's not the point. This episode is supposed to be really special, and I need to pick some of that up, and you were supposed to go with me, but you don't have an ID? That doesn't make any sense.
Well,
how am I supposed to get bought? I have $60 set apart. For this scene, for this part, and it's really important, you know. I thought you were supposed to be a guide.
We're gonna get out of here, and we're gonna figure it out. I know where to get mid, man, or my name's not... You know, we got this. We're gonna make it.
Let's go, I guess.
I said, come on!
I just don't understand what this is. Why did you bring me to this?
Like, why'd I bring you here?
Yeah.
Well, you said you wanted to see the centralized point, Colorado Couture, and so I took you to the tower. A mainline... Spire, baby. Listen to me, Jackson. This is where the people come and congregate. The hotels, the businesses. They're the fucking Carl's Jr., man, if you're hungry. It's everything. It's Colorado. It's real.
No. You told me you were a cultural guide.
I'm cultural.
And I wanted to see the culture. You know, the pot smokers, the festivals, you know, that cool stuff.
Well, I'm 100% honest, man. Listen, I've been paid freelance. I don't 100% know what a guide is. But people don't just come around, walk around, just, look at me, man. I'm the mid, man. I'm smoking weed, man. It's fucking stupid, all right? All right, listen to Gustafur. No one acts like that. It's fucking ridiculous. So what we do is we're not going to be Emilio Estevez and celebrate pot. We're going to figure it out. Because I'm going to show... I shut the tower. The long, blunt tower, man.
It's pretty tall. Right. I will give you that. It's pretty tall.
What do you think it does?
You're supposed to tell me this stuff. I don't know.
Well, fine. Let me show you something I do know.
You still haven't even found me marijuana. Are you going to find me marijuana?
What's that?
Weed.
Oh! Well, this whole time, man, I've been hipping on it. Listen, I've been tired. Oh, I need a nap. All right, man. I know exactly where the hot trees are, where to keep them il discreto, where we can get hot and bothered, legalized marijuana, weedicles, whatever you want.
Okay, I don't see any dispensaries around here. Is this a goof?
What?
Are you goofing me again?
It's not a fucking crank. It's not a goof. What, you got shipper brains, dude? It's right here. Right in front of us.
Here?
This is where you get the trees.
Are you kidding me? Dollar Tree?
Yeah.
Oh, my God.
The fucking Dollar Tree. Let's just walk in. I'm gonna get this going. I should not tell anyone this, but all right, be cool, babies, okay? What you do, so you know, I know.
This is what you were talking about.
Shut the fuck up. This is Jackson. This is listen.
Jackson.
Can you just meet me around back soon? Yeah, can just meet you talking.
Give me 10 minutes.
10 minutes.
10 minutes.
All right, babe.
Yeah. Get out of here.
I'm fucking gone. We got this. We got this.
Get out.
Isn't that what you wanted, Jason? Thank you. You guys have a wonderful day.
This is getting out of hand.
What's getting?
We shouldn't be taking drugs behind this dumpster. This is too sketchy. Behind the Dollar Tree.
First of all, listen to me. If you want hot weed, you go to Dollar Tree. Secondly, you buy weed behind dumpsters. That's what you do. Why are you sketching out? It's legal. We're in Colorado,
that's
man.
That's the point. It's legal, yet we're buying it back here. And I'm not going to go to jail for this shit. This is nuts. I am an internet figure.
Trust
okay?
me, man.
People recognize me.
One, I might be an internet figure myself. You don't know me. Okay. And secondly, when you trust me, don't worry about no legal shit. Don't worry about no cops, baby. Don't worry about Alex. I got this because when you're with the Gestapo, you're in good hands.
See, that's
man.
The problem. I don't think you're Gustav.
Why?
I think you're just some guy who's playing me, playing us for this money.
So you think I'm some like funny ass like weirdo comes out of nowhere, just walks in the hallways, does whatever, smokes weed, rich whoever.
I don't know. I feel uncomfortable about this whole situation.
Wait. Actually, I'm forgetting about it. Now, speaking of money, she'd probably be here any second because that took us like 20 minutes to walk here, or whatever, and we only probably got like 500, 400 seconds left. So I'm gonna need you to hand me 100 bucks, 60 bucks, 70 bucks. I don't know, money. Hand me $60. You got 60 bucks in there?
I mean. I only have, you know, 100.
No, 200.
That
works. All right, so we're gonna walk over here, and I'm gonna, she'll be, just give me a minute. We got this. Okay, listen, right?
Sure.
Hey.
Hey. Ready or what?
I'm fucking ready, if you're fucking ready.
Hey, that's not Where's my fucking money?
Well, where's the stuff?
I can't watch.
Here, I'll give you the money. Good shit. Come on, buddy. Come on, buddy. Come on. Yeah, that's a change. Got a change, buddy? Come on. Come on. Come on. Come on. Come
on. Fucking touch me. Hey.
All right. Thank you, man.
Good? Hey,
we're good. We're good.
Good.
All right, we're all paid up. All right. All right, buddy.
That was outrageous.
Come on. Hey, girl. Hey, no. Come on.
I'll keep it on you.
You ready?
Okay.
Oh,
let's
shake
let's
my
get
hand.
Out of here.
Shake my hand.
Let's get out of here.
All right, man. All right. Well, we're here.
Where the heck are we? I thought we were gonna smoke somewhere.
We are gonna smoke right here in private.
In private? I thought you could smoke here legally.
We're gonna smoke right up there.
What's up there?
My place.
Your place?
Mm-hmm. It's a nice, you're gonna be fucking surprised, man.
I'm already surprised. I've been surprised all day.
Yeah, it's a long walk,
it's,
man.
It's a heck of a walk here.
Yeah. Yeah, righto, we're gonna be safe. You got me, you got Alfredo. You're gonna be fine.
Oh, wow. Oh, that's crazy.
Yeah, how you liking, man?
Well, it's rather luxurious.
And pretty damn spacious.
Really spacious.
And damn straight, baby.
Wow.
Yeah, it was a gift from the Greeks. It's all wood or something. All right, man.
Wow.
Home sweet home.
This view is incredible.
Oh, you like that, baby?
This is insane.
All right. Well, you're gonna have a lot more to like when we get inside of here, okay, Lex?
Wow.
All right, let's unlock the door.
Okay.
Durr.
What are you doing?
What have I been doing? I'm unlocking my door.
Well, you said you lived here.
I do live here. You never use a spoon to unlock a door like a fucking normal person?
What?
Oh, I'm just looking around.
Yeah. Okay.
Well. That ain't gonna work. Sorry, Spoon.
Oh.
But that sure fucking will. Everybody, let's come inside, go upstairs, wipe your feet off. We're gonna get real pretty in a second. All right. on, baby. All right, boys. What I'm gonna need you to do is pick your poison, all right? Whoa. We got bongs, we got pipes,
that's really intimidating.
Hey, man, you said you wanted to smoke.
These are already loaded.
Of course they're already loaded. You wanted to smoke weed.
Then why did we go and buy weed if you already had weed?
There's the whole fucking reason you hired me, man, is because you wanted to buy weed! Bitch.
Okay.
It's gonna be
on it. Okay, first of all,
yeah,
we're gonna have to replace that water. That's why I brought mine. Okay? I'm very specific. It's just, it's one of those things, but we're just, yeah, we're gonna have to replace this. Yeah, okay. Oh, okay, what? Oh my.
Oh. All right.
What the fuck is wrong with you? What is wrong with you?
I just wanted the fucking more water in, man. I'll do it.
Oh my god. I don't know if this is the right circumstance. I'm not feeling comfortable.
You're gonna love this, buddy.
Oh.
That tastes like piss compared to this.
Oh.
All right, boys. I want you to have Greenero Eno. I'll light it up for you. Come on, you got this. Ready? Put your mouth to it.
Okay, zooming up. Zooming out.
Do I pull it?
Yeah.
You pull it, buddy. You put your mouth on it, too.
Adios.
Hey, boy. That's good. That's good.
I am blown. Gustav, I know you're kind of busy, but I gotta take a light pee.
Fuck, dude, second.
What?
What? It's eight. All right, man, we gotta go. We gotta get the fuck out of here.
What?
We gotta get the fuck out of now. Right.
You said you own this house.
Well, I mean, I've been squatting here for a better time. Grab across the nasty. Yeah, my smokes.
Where is it? Here?
Go on, just keep going right up. Right to my special hammock.
Oh my god.
My secret spot.
Oh, we got him, man.
So we're good, right?
No.
We're good.
We're not fucking good. We're not fucking good. This is too far.
What's wrong, man? This is what you want.
No.
It's a Colorado Adventure. What do you call it?
I'm fucking done with Colorado. I'm calling the manager.
Who's the manager?
The producer of this whole thing, this show. Adriano from the Mooring Line. The Mooring Line makes this show, and they're gonna get me out of here.
Adriano?
I don't have any fucking service.
From the Mooring Line?
Yeah.
How do you know him? How do you know him, man? Jackson! How do you know him, man?
How do you know him? How do you know him, baby?
Whoa. What the hell is going on?
I got a message for Adriano.
What the fuck?
Why don't you give me this camera, D? Jackson said I could have it. I love these things, man. All right. Woo! Gotta get the fuck out of Dodge. All right. Hey, Adriano. Got a message for you from the mid-man. Man, I'm through with it, man. Two for two, acting pretty. The mid-man's back, baby! And this time, I ain't playing mind games.
Hey, what's going on, guys? It's your boy, Adriano. You know who it is. Beautiful May weather out here today. Don't have Dimitri the cameraman with me, so forgive me for this vlog style. But I'm about to head on to Conway, Arkansas, see what old Sumner boy's doing. He's still at his parents' house. I'm gonna go cheer him up, make him do a video with me, you know? Force him, make him feel guilty. Say, hey, I drove all this way to make a video with you. Come on, let's do it, you know? So, I'll update you when I get there.
Monday. I thought you were gonna All right. Looks like we're pulling up on Sumner's house in this beautiful upper middle class neighborhood. Look at these houses. Isn't that great? All right.
Yeah, he's definitely home. There's the old Sumsmobile.
Well, I guess I'll just park behind him. Yep.
What's up?
What's up, dude?
I didn't know. Just chilling. I did not know you would be in town.
Yeah.
Yeah, there you go.
I just thought...
Don't come through the pillars. What's going on?
I'm in Conway. I decided, man, I needed to film a video I don't have anyone to film with. So I thought I'd check up on you, see what you're doing, see if you wanted to film something.
I mean, you could have fucking called first, but you know, I mean, like, I'm down, you know. It's a gorgeous day.
It is pretty sweet.
Pretty sick. Yeah. You haven't been to my house in a minute, have you?
No.
Yeah. You know, we've got the garage. We got Mr. Trump Dump over there. My family's big on the conservative politics. And Buzz Aldrin.
Buzz Aldrin, wow.
Yeah.
Got your setup out here.
Yeah, I got my jamming, you know, my git and my peds and my amps and my signals. Yeah, I mean, since I come home, February 7th, I believe it was, this is mainly where I've been chilling. It's been getting hot lately, so I've been sleeping downstairs. But yeah, when I'm up and home and chilling, reading, taking in some movies, I am up here.
Yeah, but...
Yeah, it's cozy.
It's a lot of tea.
Oh,
How's your caffeine addiction?
Well, okay, the caffeine addiction remains the same, but... I have made significant progress in the sense that I'm totally off the mods.
Really?
Yeah, for good. So I haven't had one since I came back, you know, February 7th, yeah. And I've been on, you know, frequenting the Starbs, drinking a lot of coffee.
Man, I should have stopped off somewhere for some, like, caffeine or something myself. I don't normally drink caffeine.
Yeah, dude.
You got anything to drink in here?
No, I don't actually.
Is that a... Monst 4-pack?
No, I mean, if there's a pack of Monst in there, they're probably my sister's boyfriend.
You just got done telling me that you're off the Monst for good.
There's
a Monst 4-pack. Sumner, you know what I think? I think that these monsters are getting in the way of your creativity. But it's getting in the way. It's getting in the way.
Yeah, I know. But look, I have not had a Monst since I came home February 7th, okay.
Then what are those?
Those are my reserves.
Your reserves?
Yeah.
Your stock Monster reserves?
Yeah, it's like sometimes if you find yourself wondering if you can cope with, you know, the cold realities of the universe, you know, you think you can carry on, but you keep a pistol in your desk, you know, just in case.
Oh my God.
Now, the metaphor is apt because if at any point you've been drinking as much Monst as I had before I came back home, you would also kill yourself.
I can't believe you're using Monst as a vice. Yeah, you're not drinking Monst. Man, look at this. Look at this. You're on the tea and the cough.
Yeah.
That's
Look at
barely better.
That's lies.
I'm gonna fix
this. Green tea is full of antioxidants and coffee I know is great for you. I don't know specifically.
I'm gonna fix your creative drive.
Coffee's good for the dick.
I'm gonna fix it.
Alright.
What do you mean it's good for the dick?
It's good for you get a strong dick if you drink coffee on the regular. Black coffee.
Says who?
Says like science.
I presume your laptop's in that bag.
Yeah.
Get it out, please.
What?
Just trust me. You know, I've been more open-minded lately. I've been influenced by your spirituality and stuff.
Oh.
And I've come up with a method, I think, that could really help you get over this Monst addiction.
You know, man, I don't think I need it necessarily, but
look, I think it's for your creativity. I've just been feeling this lately.
All right.
Are you familiar with dimension jumping?
The interdimensional planes and like the Hulk, like, you know, the Hulk jumps are, but it doesn't sound like you know.
I came across this subreddit called r/dimension jumping.
Oh, a subreddit.
Yeah, come on, dude.
Well,
everyone uses Reddit, don't fuck with me.
Okay, you're right, I do too. Dimensional jumping, 982? Okay.
Yeah.
So what am I, how are you fixing me?
So basically we need a candle and a mirror.
whatever dimension jumping is, there's no established theory of jumping or its mechanism, although there are numerous ways of viewing its nature. You know, everything is subjective. Wow. All these describe the same technique, which is detaching from the current sensory pattern. You kind of reshift your brain's formatting, and you trigger like a replacement, deliberate or accidental alignment via mood association.
Yeah, this is gonna seem kind of ridiculous, but I think we might as well try it.
Yeah.
So I'm sure you have some candles around here.
Yeah, kind of mirror. Yeah.
Relax. Clear your mind. Concentrate on your reflection. View your reflection as another you. A you from a different place. Concentrate on switching places with that you. It's kind of similar to astral projection, but it's a little bit different.
Yeah, we can do this.
So if we do it right, we should. My theory is that we can shift to a dimension where you have no caffeine or monster addiction, and it just, we need to shift to a dimension where monster just tastes bad to you, and then you'll be cured.
Yeah.
And it's like, you gotta taste the monster.
It's like hypnosis.
Yeah, it's like hypnosis, cooler. But yeah, way cooler. Okay.
Let's do it.
Let's
hop on.
Aesthetics.
Hey, here,
we'll
get this candle.
Oh, okay.
Candle.
Bet.
Sexy cinnamon.
Huh.
Alright.
Oh, sick. That's
Let's
perfect.
Jump, dude. Let's jump, bro.
Dude, I don't think sexy cinnamon really fits the vibe. You have anything like more spiritual, something more like theatrical? Cinnamon?
Yeah, sexy cinnamon. I may have something more on the ornamental side.
Okay, yeah. Because, yeah, yeah. I mean, it would just look cooler.
Yeah, I get you. Give me a second.
Okay.
A little more.
Yeah.
Ornamental.
That's perfect. Yeah, that looks great.
That's something.
Looks like you're in that Eddie Murphy movie, The Haunted Mansion. Okay.
Okay.
Now, this is not the best angle of me, but we'll deal. We'll deal.
Yeah.
Okay. So, clear our minds.
Yeah. Focus on the other dimension.
Do you feel a shift? I don't feel anything.
I still feel trapped within the shittiest possible dimension of Trump's America.
Yeah. Yeah, I'm not feeling as spiritual as I was. I don't know. I don't know if this is working. I don't know if I should be filming or what.
Yeah, maybe that's throwing it off.
You know, actually.
But,
you know, I got something in the car that could help us, actually.
Help how?
Just, I went to the Cracker Barrel with my family the other night. And I found something that was pretty interesting on, you know.
Cracker Barrel.
Yeah, the Cracker Barrel. I know. Yeah, it's ridiculous. But
okay.
Just hold on. I'm going to go out to the car.
I believe.
I'm so glad I brought this. I knew it would come in handy. All right. So this is going to seem kind of ridiculous, but, you know, you're open-minded. Now, I have this drink. It's called McFuddy. Look at that. No, no, just look. It says, infused with luck, 12 ounces for 24 hours of favorable outcomes.
Oh, it's infused with luck in Mucoletto, Washington.
I thought at the least it'll give us good vibes or something. I don't know. If we take half each, that's like 12 hours of good luck.
Yeah, for both 12 of us. Yeah, I feel you.
So I was thinking we give that a try.
Yeah, dude.
Try it all over again.
Anything's possible.
Yeah. See what happens.
All right.
Save some luck for me, man.
Mm.
How's it taste? I know it's warm, but
like intense Dr. Pepper. Dude, it'll fucking hit. Fizzy shit. Yeah. Don't go down easy.
That's really weird.
Yeah, dude.
I think I can taste it working, though. All right, we're all potioned up. Cool. All right,
you want to give it another...
I guess we'll give it another try.
White-a-roni.
Okay.
Dimension dumping 2.0.
Take two, I guess.
Yeah, we'll see.
Okay, clear my mind.
Right.
Clear my mind.
Ooh. There we go.
All right.
Is that Dude,
holy shit.
Is that supposed to be happening?
What the? Focus.
What do we do, man? I don't.
Whoa. What the fuck?
Should I blow it out?
No. This might be a good thing.
This could be a very bad thing.
Empty your mind.
What the fuck?
It fucking worked. What the fuck?
Shit.
Oh my god.
What the fuck?
What are you wearing?
I have no idea, but it's breezy.
What the fuck? Oh. Are we at the summit house? How did we get to the fucking summit house? What is going on?
Dude,
this is nuts.
It looked like the summit house. What?
My fucking tattoo's gone. My conja club tattoo's fucking gone. And you're wearing a goddamn dress. What the fuck? Oh my god.
What did you do?
Oh my god, dude.
What have you done?
Look at this.
What
the fuck? This is fucking nuts. Okay. I get it. We're in some fucking esoteric dimension. And this is gonna cure your monster habit, dude. This is it. I get it. I fucking get it.
I'm on the scene.
You have to drink. I don't care. This is it, dude. You have to drink that can.
No.
There's no way out of it.
No. I don't know what that is.
Do you understand? Do you listen? Look.
I don't know if this is the summit house.
This is nuts. This is obviously something to it. This is nuts. You have to drink it, dude. Why else? Look at this shit. This is fucking vile.
I'm not drinking that.
You're fucking drinking it, dude.
No.
You're fucking drinking it.
Oh, really?
Yeah,
drink it. Really?
Oh, you fucker.
Yeah, okay.
Dude, this could be our only fucking
dude,
way out. Do you understand?
Dude, drink it.
Drink it.
Fuck, dude.
Drink it.
No.
Yes.
No. Fuck.
Fuck you, dude.
No.
You don't understand how this works.
No.
You don't. Oh, my God.
No.
Drink it. Drink it, you bastard. It's gonna hurt. It's
no.
probably like that fucking
no.
Half-Blood Prince scene.
No. No.
It's probably like, you know, with
no.
Dumbledore.
No!
You're almost done.
No more.
You're almost done.
No. I can't. No.
This is it.
No.
You're almost done.
No, please don't.
One more sip, I swear. One more sip.
Please.
One more swear.
No.
Okay. That's the last of it. I promise. It's for your own fucking good, Sumner. It's for your own fucking good.
I think.
Did it work?
I think I'm cured.
Oh shit. Oh fuck. Dude, maybe you didn't drink it all. There's a tiny fucking bit in there. Yeah, there's a little bit. There's like one sip left. There's one sip left, Sumner. Hear that? That's it. That's all you have to take. Sumner.
Just one more?
One more. Just sit in that chair.
Just
and take the last sip, and we can get the fuck out of here, I think.
Just give it.
I mean, we warped here. We can warp back.
Just give it.
Okay. That's it. It's done. It's over. Herbalistic. No, that's it. That's the.
It was in this moment that the songs you know and love was burned with the fullest understanding of the cosmic hell awaiting him for the rest of eternity. Through the dimensional shaman Adriano, the cosmos placed him at the foot of his psyche's alchemical purification palace, but alas, he found himself tainted by imperfect courage. He was always going to drink, for it was his destiny. However, when offered the chance for an astral cleansing worth 10 lifetimes, he shrank away. However, his destiny was close to him, and he was forever doomed to a ceaseless purgatory of reliving the last putrid sip of the potion forever emblematic of his failure to get off the monst.
Thank you. is in our hands. You don't understand. You just became a parent. But you have to take responsibility.
I believe the children are our future.
Oh, you know what? You have ruined my life. You have ruined my life. I have to live with this now.
Oh, you bet he does.
Oh, you hear that? I am fucked, and you fuck me. I am fucked, and you fuck me. I am fucked.
Not right. What the fuck?
Dude, are we at the fucking sack?
What the hell is on your finger?
Dude, what happened to my fucking finger?
How the fuck am I supposed to know?
This is fucked, dude. This is fucked.
Hold the fuck up, Sumner. We gotta think this through. Stop. Get your hands off. This could be a fucking different dimension for all we know. We gotta figure this out together. You got us into this goddamn shit. We gotta find a black cube or a candle and fucking figure it out because this could be fucked. I don't even know if this is real. This could be some
manipulative. You know what? Shut the fuck up. Okay, one. Post-dimension jumping? Yeah, I had a month's coffee addiction. Okay, I'll admit that. Two, nobody asked you to cure that shit.
I was just being a good friend.
Three, I don't give a shit. No, you're being selfish is what you were being. You needed me to dimension jump. Three, you took us dimension jumping. You just wanted another soul to dimension jump with. It wasn't about monster.
It wasn't about coffee. Dude. I want to make sure we're in the right place and not in some fuck dimension.
Me too. That's why I'm done listening to you.
We gotta fucking figure this out, okay? Fucking Cody, isn't it?
Hey guys, knew I'd find you here. Predictable. You guys knew it. What are we doing? It's Cody time. We got this, man. It's time to rock. It's ready. It's Lake House. What are you two doing here at the sack? Why'd I even know to find you here? Nothing makes any sense. You got a dimension finger. If so, fact so, you're both fucking predictable. I'm the cool one. End of discussion. Check this out. Look at these shades. I got this. So what's up? What are we doing? I'm hungry.
Cody!
What the hell are you doing here? I thought you lived in Colorado. How'd you get here? And how'd you know we'd be here right now? I don't know what happened, okay?
We dimension jumped.
We landed at the shack through some black cube shit. I don't know what's going on. Some dark magic.
First of all, fuckers, I found your black cube, all right? And I'm done with it. And we're both done with it. Secondly, I never lived in Colorado, all right? I've been living here with you guys. We live in Benton. And if you're talking about the fucking Summit Hotel, we only fucking stayed there to film a video. We were in Colorado, we filmed a fucking video, filmed a bunch of fucking videos. All I do is fucking videos, and I'm fucking sick of it. But you know what? You guys just sound insane, all right? I don't know what the fuck we're doing. I don't know what the fuck's going on. Sumner has some transdimensional finger. I'm pissed. Ape shit fucking pissed. Abstract. And I just realized something. I'm not wearing my glasses anymore, and that's a continuity error. So fuck you guys. Fuck all of you, all right? I'm done with black cubes. I don't even know anything about dimensions. You guys never even fucking included me. Where have I been?
What do you mean you didn't live in Colorado? I fucking flew me and Dimitri out there to fucking film that virtual tour guide. What do you mean you were never in Colorado?
You indeed did go to Colorado with me and Sophia, okay? It was both of us.
You're telling me that Sumner and I didn't live at the Summit House for a year of our lives? What, was it just our imagination?
No, we never lived in that fucking hotel. We just filmed a bunch of videos fucking there and now we're living in fucking Benton. You, me, and Sophia live in Benton. Benton, Arkansas, where the fucking your dad's restaurant is, dude. That's where we fucking live.
Cody, you have been in Colorado this whole time. Do not lie to me and tell me any different.
Okay. You have no idea what's going on. He has no idea what we're talking about, and I don't care. I don't care. I'm done. I'm out.
What do you mean you're fucking out?
No, I'm going back to school. I'm done with creativity. Sumner. I'm done with art. I want to die in a cubicle, Adrian.
Sumner!
I want to die in a cubicle.
Come back, dude. Sumner, no, you can't leave me in this dimension by myself. No.
Hey, you got something?
What?
You're not by yourself.
I'm not?
You got Cody Long. And you know what we're about to go do? Get the fuck out of this heat and play some fucking Smash.
I'm so down.
Yeah.
Dank!
Greetings to our overlords, the Illuminati, Sele, the powers that be, whatever you'd like to be called. My name is Adriano, and this is a virtual resume of sorts. Now look, we all know that New World Order is coming, okay? It's in the mix. People are already starting to accept it. I say bring it on, because look around us. Trump is president, MoviePass is dead, and CERN is trying to resurrect the Hindu god Shiva to bring on the end of the world. It's the perfect time for you guys to swoop in. The Earth is vulnerable. And that's where I come in, because as a documentarian, I will gladly document New World propaganda for you guys. All I'm asking for in exchange is permission to fully upload my consciousness when the time comes. Oh, and it will come. Trust me. But I suppose you'd like to see a short demo of my work. I assure you, I have the correct qualifications, okay? Here's a short clip from my full-length documentary, Christmas in Vegas, which, if you check, has over 1,000 views. Roll the tape.
Merry Christmas, Quinn. Threw all the money away.
It's just we've reached, like, peak economic despair.
Now see, I have the necessary skills. I capture atmosphere, okay? But I also capture the truth. And the truth is that the global elitists are currently buying up all the property in New Zealand in an attempt at creating some sort of elitist paradise. As if it's a safety net against the upcoming revolution, am I right? But I'm getting sidetracked here. Now look, if y'all are like transdimensional beings, or you're being controlled by transdimensional beings, you're in luck, because my brain capacity and my IQ are actually at the exact level they need to be for my mind to be fully prepared to travel across any and all dimensions. So there's no problem there. Now, in closing, I'd like to remind you, I'm not a shill, and I'm not a paranoid nut. Okay, I'm just an all-American filmmaker looking for his big break. And this could be the biggest break of them all. So, Illuminati, please choose me as your New World Order documentarian. I will not let you down. Good night. God, you mean I'm still in this goddamn place? For fuck's sakes. What is this? I would never be a clean boy. This is ridiculous.
The holy summer bomb comes forward, and the balance is pushed to a new truth. You just got a bad Carly's mom.
No. This is not right. This is not right. I would never be a clean boy. What is this? I would never be a clean boy. Get this shit out of my face.
Our new introductory series comes at a mere $340 donation, which in return is a priceless asset towards our goal of mining the caracom to implement the greasy death third strike.
Wait, what the hell is... what is all this? Music video? An Evangelion AMV? Is that what I've been up to? Making AMVs? You know what? No, I like these. This is, you know, it's something. It's better than not putting out content, I guess.
You know, these hamburgers are quite similar to the ones they have at Krusty Burger.
Oh, no. Patented Skinner Burger's old family recipe.
Oh, for fuck's sake. Steamed hams? I'm making steamed ham videos, too?
Yeah. So you call them steamed hams, despite the fact they are obviously grilled. You know, one thing I should... Excuse me for 1 second.
Secondly, I never lived in Colorado.
We jumped. We landed the shack through some black cube shit. Like, I don't know what's going on. Some dark magic.
First of all, fuckers, I found your black cube. All right, and I'm done.
Okay, first of all, since when have you been a supremo vape boy? Second of all, what the fuck is going on and where the hell am I?
First of all, it's hype beast, thank you. And I gotta quit smoking. Second, you told me that you were gonna go to sleep in the back of your van. And once you emerged, you're gonna forget everything for the past 2 years.
I don't even own a fucking van, dog.
I think you've been living in that thing for about a year.
What do you mean a year? Like I'm a bum? Do I not have a job?
I mean, you've been down and out.
What do you mean down and out? What happened?
How am I supposed to know any of that?
What did I do in there?
Again, how am I supposed to know any of that?
Whew. Okay, well, I'd say the first thing we need to do is destroy this then.
All right, bet.
So where is everybody? Like, where's Cody at?
Cody? Cody hasn't left Colorado, dude.
Never happened here either. Well, what about Sumner and Savannah? They're still at the Summit House, right?
What the fuck is the Summit House? That place doesn't exist, dude.
Oh my god, no way!
Thank you.
fuck it. I feel creative. I'm back. Let's start season 4, baby, from the ground up. Let's fucking film, bro.
Well, Cody told me to give you a little message. Let the past die.
Star Wars at me, you son of a bitch.
Yeah, let's just fucking film.
All right.
It's time for Top 10 Ethnicities Ranked! Alright, let's get into it. Number 10! Ooh, I just can't look anymore. This is too outrageous. Shit, man, he hasn't utilized any of us this season. I knew it. We're done for. Yeah, I mean, his last video was about a video game, for goodness sake. It's for the best. What? Believe it or not, Adrian seems to be on the right path again. The split in 2066, it'll still happen. Some Scorp will rise. For now, we just ride it out. Perhaps we could just bring him in briefly. Play it off as a dream. Just convince him to do another Pablo video. I mean, Jesus is King just came out. It's perfect timing. No, Adrian shall be left alone. He's back doing what he truly wants. But Adriano, on the other hand, he could be rectified. Yeah, I've got an idea.
Oh?
It's time for a new character. What, like Keith Cologne? No! What? No. No. Fuck that guy. This will actually be fresh for the channel. Yes. I have foreseen it. I believe that it's time for us to use our influence. Just this once.
Agreed.
Yep. Agreed. So, have either of you seen Hereditary? You! You son of a bitch. Okay, quick, give me the cube. And you take the tracksuit. What? Why? You just gotta trust me. You gotta put it on. It's the only way this is gonna work. All right. Yes!
I'd say the first thing we need to do is destroy this then.
All right, bet.
Adriano!
Ben!
What? No! I'm Audrey, you retard!
You can't say that!
Oh, well, guess what? I'm canonically autistic, so, yeah, I think I can. But that's neither here nor there, okay? It's time for you to leave this place, and we are going to help you just this once.
Man, honestly, I think I'm just better off in this state. No responsibilities, no concept of time. Come on, why don't you come back and get me in, what year is this, 2019? Come get me in 47 years.
Hello? Don't you want to see the new Star Wars movie? How else are you going to tell people over and over and over again that you think Ray's a Mary Sue if you don't exist? Fuck! That's so true! Damn! Fine. I guess I'm ready to be brought up. Keep in mind that there is a very limited window here, okay? You must escape the door, please. LaCroix?
Alright, both of you. Come on, hands out.
Alright, both of you. Come on. Hands out. I swear, dude, this has to be the last time that this happens.
Thank you.
henceforth, you shall be known as the King of all Kino. The Kino Cowboy.
All hail 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 the Kino Cowboy.
Trump's war on the mooring line ends now!